What's up guys, it's Louis here. I hope you missed my Afrikaans accent. In today's video, we are going to have a quick look at Woolworths. Previously, we looked at Pick n Pay and Shoprite. So with that said, I'm going to jump straight into this video and talk about the fundamentals of Woolworths and whether it's a good stock compared to Pick n Pay and Shoprite. And to be honest, at the moment, Shoprite has been my favorite one so far. So feel free to let me know what you guys think. I recently started investing with a platform called BROKSTOCK, which is an easy to use platform, especially for beginners. It also has a lot of advanced features and you can even margin trade on this platform. With that said, if you transfer your money to BROKSTOCK and you do not invest it just yet, you can earn up to 7% interest on your money, which basically serves as a savings account. That's a great way to grow your money with taking little to no risk while you decide on which stocks or companies to invest in. I would recommend downloading the app, using my link down in the description, sign up and deposit your first amount and start earning some interest while you wait on buying your first stock. Just to let you guys know, if you use my link, I get paid a small incentive and it just helps to keep the channel going. With that out of the way, let's jump straight into Woolworths. So what I've done is to download the latest 26 weeks report from Woolworths website. There's a couple of things that I wanted to share with you guys. So most of the time, the first couple of pages, the company will share some really important information with you. And one of the things that I wanted to share is that with Woolworths specifically, they mentioned that the economic environment in South Africa remains challenging, exacerbated by the country's energy and logistics crisis, which continue to impact both businesses and consumer confidence. Notwithstanding the challenging context, the combined South African business grew operating profit by 10% on the last year. So this is important to take into consideration. And then next, they share the outlook of the company with us, which is also very important. They say the outlook for the rest of the financial year is expected to remain challenging. So this is quite interesting to hear from Woolworths. And again, this is something that has been shared throughout all the retail companies. Something else that's worth considering is that Woolworths actually reduced their dividend with around 6.6%, which isn't necessarily the best thing to see. Next, we'll scroll down to the good stuff and we'll start with the income statement. Like you can see, I already highlighted the stuff that's important and we'll touch on revenue first. And here we can see over the 26 weeks from the previous year, their revenue grew with 5.8%, the gross profit grew with 4%, but the expenses, store costs, and other operating costs rose with 9.9%, 9.6%, and 10.5%. This is likely due to load shedding overall, as well as some other issues that the company faced. If we scroll down and we have a look at the profit for the period, here we can see that the profit dropped a massive 33.5%, and at the end of the day, they only made 1.8 billion rand profit compared to the previous year's 26 weeks of 2.7 billion rand. Next, we're going to scroll down to the balance sheet, and this is really important, and I wasn't really too impressed looking at their balance sheet. So first of all, we can see that their non-current assets has grown, but if we go down to its current assets, we can see that it dropped from 36 billion to 12 billion rand. Another thing that worries me is the cash and cash equivalents that dropped from 6 billion rand to 2.9 billion rand, which is basically half. This is something that we need to monitor going forward. And like we can see, the total assets dropped from 61 billion to 39 billion, which is probably due to the assets they held for sale. Next, if we look at the equity has gone down as well. Not too much, but again, it's something worth considering. If we have a look at the current liabilities, which is liabilities that is due within the next 12 months, we can see that they dropped their current liabilities from 34 billion to 12 billion. 12 billion rand, which is insane. That is a lot of debt reduction. If we look at the liabilities associated with assets for sale, we can see that it's mainly due to assets that they sold, which gave them this big reduction with their current liabilities. One thing I always do is to check the current ratio of a company, which is a basic liquidity ratio to check the financial position of a company, where we divide the current assets with the current liabilities. And here we can see that Woolworths has 12 billion rand in current assets and 12 billion rand in current liabilities, which gives them a current ratio of 1. In my opinion, this is definitely not good enough for the type of companies that I like to buy. So this again is something that we need to consider going forward. The total liabilities has gone down, which is great, but the current ratio is not impressive at all. Next, we jump to our free cash flow statement. And here we can see the cash generated by operating activities is also down from 6.5 billion to 4.5 billion, which is a big reduction. Something that we need to understand is that dividends get paid from cash generated by operations, which means that if the company's cash generated by operations goes down, they will generally reduce its dividends, which isn't necessarily a bad move. A lot of companies keep their dividend the same, but at the end of the day, they run out of money. So this is very important to monitor going forward. The net cash inflow from operating activities is down from 3.4 billion to 1.6 billion. Next, if we have a look at free cash flow, which is a very important factor to me, we take our net cash inflow from operating activities and deduct investment in property, plant and equipment. And here we can see it's 1.6 billion minus 6.92 million, which gives us a free cash flow of 957 million rand. This is a significant reduction compared to the previous period, where they had 2.7 billion rand in free cash flow. With the latest interim results, they had a free cash flow margin of 1.31%, which is not too good in my opinion. Woolworths is a great company to invest in. It has a lot of potential in the longer term, but it is facing short-term headwinds like many other retail companies in South Africa. I prefer to invest in companies that can generate massive amounts of free cash flow, because that just mitigates the risk in so many different ways. And at the end of the day, cash is king when it comes to these large companies. If you had to choose Woolworths or Shoprite, which one would you choose? To be honest, I'm leaning more towards Shoprite instead of Woolworths.